So now that we've learned a little bit about the color spaces, let's take some time to go through the gel picker. I'm gonna go ahead and add that to my space. You'll notice the first thing that happens when I add my gel picker to my color picker tab is that my color space gets a bunch of little dots on it. And those dots are representative of where those gels lie in the color space. So that's a helpful little thing to look for. If you grab your mouse while you're in this space as well, you hover over those dots, it'll show you what the gel is and the name of it. So it's very easy to find particular gels and click to them, even on the color space. These dots are specific to the manufacturer that's being displayed in the gel picker. So if I pop over to Lux or up to Apollo or into Lee, you'll notice that my dots change on my color picker. So we're going to land on Roscoe Lux. There are a couple of other areas in my navigation bar for my gel picker. The first is sort by hue. And with that enabled, it takes my gel library and sorts them by hue rather than sorting them by gel book number. And if I toggle that off, they go back to alphanumeric organization. The other thing that I can toggle on and off is the similar button. So if I hit similar, it will show me gels that are right around the same area as I am in the color picker. So if I move to different locations, I get a different assortment of gels that populate. This is also gel book specific. So right now I'm seeing all of the gels that are nearby in my Roscoe Lux book. If I pop over to Lee, I'll see all the gels that are available in that area. And what's kind of convenient about this is a great way to find gels that are nearby between books. So if I look at 131 specifically and I pop back over to Lux, I'll see that 93 is my closest gel match. And to toggle out of that mode, I can just turn off my similar. Another area of the gel picker that's helpful is my show color area. And my show color area shows me all of the static gels that are loaded into my show file. And this auto-populates from patch. So if you have put any gel colors in the gel field of patch, or you have any scroller loads, this automatically populates the palette of your show so that you can manage all of your color, either mixed or static, in one place. There's one other area of the gel picker navigation pane that is pretty important, and it determines what type of color match we do when you use a gel pick. For example, I'm going to bring my channel 31 to full. And if I touch RO5, it takes me to the brightest spectral match of that fixture. If you're in a color system that has more than three color components, such as an RGBA, a 7-color system, RGBW, there are going to be multiple ways that you can get to the same chromaticity for each of these colors. We give you several options to choose from. The brightest, which is highlighted currently, takes me to the brightest of that chromaticity. I can toggle that so that whenever I select a gel from my gel picker, it will be the closest spectral match to that gel. And that's out of a 575 watt long life source 4. Sometimes, depending on your gel, however, the spectral match can take out a lot of intensity. So we have a third option, which is called hybrid. And that's about a halfway point between the brightest and the best spectral match. I can also pick those varying things by holding shift and touching my gel. And we give you indicators in your live channel screen. My GR5 tells me that I'm using a gel match for Roscoe 5. And I'm currently using the brightest output because there's no indicators on there. If I hit shift, R5 again, my single dot is letting me know that I'm using the best spectral match. Shift and R5 again will show me two dots, and that indicates that I'm using the hybrid. Shift 5 one more time, and I go back to the brightest match.